Hello everyone, this is Morgan Who here, and welcome to episode 4 of Let's Play the SpongeBob SquarePants Snoopy video game. In last episode, we did everything we could in 3,000 miles of Shell City. We got every single Goopy Goopy token and every single Twist Chest. And now we should move on to Wubba Dub Dub Slip Slide in the Tub. Now, again, we're turning from Barbecue Bond, the sliding section from the game. Now, the sliding section should begin their own unique levels. So here's the first sliding level. Well, without dust slip sliding tub, we are sliding in the desert in a tub. Yes, a tub, a bathtub. And the sliding levels pretty much act exactly the same as the trying levels. Chan, just a normal. We gotta destroy the last of the towers. So it gets planned to shut up. And yeah. And just like trying levels, there are also Twist Chests in this level too. This is a bit annoying, but that's okay. Shut up, Plankton. They get 2 or 5 towers already destroyed. Now, I'm gonna kill myself. Why would I kill myself? Because, you saw up there, there was a treasure chest there. And I would like to get that treasure. Now, yeah, dying didn't we do anything, so. And now there's a bunch of noisy kids outside, ignore them. But nah, let's jump down here. So, take us to an earlier point in the level. Yeah, we're back at the beginning level. Now, why would I want to go back to here? Well, again, like I said, there's a treasure chest up there that we couldn't get. So I'll show you the poor way they're supposed to get that first treasure chest where that bowling ball rolled across and smashed the second tower. At least it gives me more dumbbells. Now you see this platform has appeared now. Jump up here. And you'll be up here on this bridge and here's your first treasure chest. On this level. Now we enter double digits for the treasure chests. I love the quote. Patrick always says in this level, "Here comes the pain drain!" And, well, yeah, we're definitely halfway through the level because this is the third tower that we've taken down. How do you say that in the last level, SpongeBob? Whatever. Always pointing rocks are coming from the sky. They easy to avoid, don't you worry. There we go. Checkpoint! And yeah, here's some enemies to kill. We're practically invisible to these enemies, so there's no need to worry. You only need to worry about bombs, pits, really. Air vents do. Yeah, red means jump. And red and blue means double jump. That's what the signs be. But I'm pretty sure you know, if I just look at them. Oh great, more rolling rocks. What is this, Indiana Jones? I never seen Indiana Jones film in my life, so please don't kill me for that. Anyways. So, yeah, we're at the end of the level. I can still hear Plankton's voice, and he's still gloating about the jump bucket and clay patties. So, okay. And yes, just like the driving levels, the sliding levels also have time ring and macho time challenges too. By the way, here's the fourth tower taken down. Boom! And give us some more dumbbells for that. 1, 2, 5, 10. Unfortunately, there's no 50. Yeah, the dumbbells go by 1, 2, 5, 10, 50. Now, jump down here. Why? Well, not only is it a shortcut. Well, is it a shortcut? I don't know. But there are also these rolling rocks they want to avoid. And most importantly, here we have a treasure chest. There you go, we only got one more treasure chest to get here. And it's quite nearby. Wash these crates, get some more dumbbells. jump. Now, why in the end jump to these up here to these temple downs on these small platforms? Use some compass for this, and you know, there's another treasure chest there. That's all the treasure chests in this sliding level. So yeah. So we're near the end level. In fact, you can see your target up there with the trampoline. So all you gotta do is jump on trampoline, and that's this level done with. All towers destroyed.
I knew you guys could do it. Here's your reward.
Oh boy!
Our heroes, having foiled Plankton's evil plans, continue across the desert. But Plankton remains one stubby step ahead of them. He sends someone to make sure that they will fail. He is a vicious, ruthless killer named Dennis. Fortunately, SpongeBob and Patrick have discovered the paddy wagon in a parking lot. But the key is missing. So the only thing to do is to go into the rough, tough bar and look for it. Good luck, my friends. You're going to need it.
You have to get the key to the paddy wagon back. Good news, Patrick! You've got enough Goofy Goober tokens for me to teach you a new ability.
My flop is the mightiest flop of all!
It's called the smash.
You could do the ass smash by jumping into the air and pressing the X button.
In the air?
Yes. You have to be in the air for the smash to work. You can use it to press buttons, break through floors, and even defeat enemies. The paddy wagon is parked outside, but you'll need to get the key back to use it.
That doesn't sound hard.
You'll probably have to defeat all of the thugs to get to it.
That sounds hard.
You can do it, I know you can.
Well, if you believe in me, then I can do it.
The key to the paddy wagon!
Careful. Easy. You got it!
You need to get the key back to start the paddy wagon. Chase that key to the far end of the thug tug if you have to.
So yeah, this is the next level, Bubble Blowing Baby Hunt. I will play as Patrick again. But we're not going to be doing this level for now. Because we still got 3 challenges to do back in the slime level. And also, yeah, that's we unlocked the new ability. It's called the BAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAAA
slide the last time.
I like to stop and smell the anemones.
And old tires.
Well, try sliding quickly instead. If you make it under the allotted time, you'll earn a reward.
Okie dokie. So like I say, we unlocked a new ability. It's called the Ass Smash, I like to call it. And basically, fun saying as the belly flop and barbecue bun. So that's all I've got to say for that. Anyways, now we're doing the three challenges in Bubba Dubba Dubs that's on the top. So yes, the slide nails had the exact same challenges as it does in the driving level, so I expect to see these a lot. So here we have the normal time challenge. This one is pretty easy, as long as you don't screw up too many times. You got 3 minutes and 4 seconds to finish this whole course in 3 hours. 3 hours. I'm screwing my words a lot today. 3 minutes and 40 seconds. So as long as you take all the shortest shortcuts possible and cut as many courses as you can, you should be able to do this. So yeah. Not much to say, it's just doing time giants again, so... must talk something. Anyway, like I said, this game is clearly based on the 2004 SpongeBob movie with the same name. I think when the first movie came out, I was 6 years old. And naturally, I loved the movie. I really do love it. And I still love it today. In fact, I watched it yesterday, actually, and it still hold up to this day. It's a pretty short movie, I find, but I still love the movie, the crusty crab too, SpongeBob trying to become manager, the goofy goof scene where they become drunk, and the paddy wagon keep getting stolen and that, the frog tough scene where SpongeBob and Patty blow bubbles, Dennis the Cyclops, so silly, oh. And of course that very sad scene where SpongeBob and Patrick nearly die. I like to personally think that the first SpongeBob movie takes place nearly at the end of the SpongeBob timeline. Like, literally. After the first 9 seasons and in the second SpongeBob movie, the first SpongeBob movie is where it ends. I like to think it's that, so that SpongeBob can have a good ending no matter what happens to it now. Even with 9 plus seasons and the second movie, I still like to think the first movie is the literal end of the SpongeBob movie. Also, if you're covering up not for your platforming abilities, take this shortcut. It cuts you off a lot of time, and especially important for the macho time challenges. So here we go. There you go, that's it. 3 minutes and 1 second. Easy.
Wow, that was fast. Here's your reward, as promised.
Oh, boy!
I've got a real challenge for you two.
Ooh, three-legged race?
Spelling shuffleboard backwards?
No. Rings will appear along this slide. You have a limited time to get through each ring. I'll reward you if you get through every ring.
So here we go, the second wing challenge, aka the first wings challenge in the slime level, and this is where the wing challenges immediately start to get pretty hard. Now, they're still not as hard as wing challenges to come in the future, but actually, the wings are starting to turn red as they push them. Yes, the wings are way cock-teasing us. That's great. And it's already in the second level, they start to take random paths that you don't expect the wings to take. Like, simple right here. They make you take a shortcut, that's fair enough. But then also, they make you force you to turn to the left and go all the way down here to an early point in the level. That's something we do hate about the wings. They take you to random paths you don't expect to. And it pins us random things like here, white, left, then white, like a huge white, and then left, and center, and then left again, and then white, zigzagging. Again, this one's quite easy. This might take a bit of a trial now, but this is easy compared to Sonic, the Peach Ranger in the name game. Honestly, these challenges are at the worst in the middle of the game. Yes, middle. And the worst match time challenge is definitely at the end of the game, but the wing challenges are at the worst in the middle. But back to the next wing challenge after this, that one could go screw itself, but for now, this one I can tolerate with. Just that new players are gonna hate these type of challenges, they want all the Goofy Goober tokens. Yeah, like I said, I hate the wings in this game. They're not the worst yet, but they sure will soon. But yeah, like I said, even though it's kind of topic, so is. I like to talk about the second SpongeBob movie, SpongeBob War, that came out last a year and a half, actually. Sponge of War. I actually like that movie, too. Where they become superheroes and... I think I've saved my thoughts about Sponge of War. Again, it's a good movie. It's isn't as epic as the first movie, but... same old, SpongeBob and Plankton get secret formula, then Plankton then disappears. Well, we need anything else, so might as well be quick. Yet the green snake could take this risky shortcut as well. Let's grab a secret formula, gets stolen by this random pirate. Then this random dolphin comes out everywhere, and I'll talk about second movie later after we finish with Wing Challenge, so yeah.
Great sliding. Here's your reward.
Oh boy!
How fast do you two think you can slide?
Does this answer your question?
Okay. Beat the manly time down the slide, and you'll be rewarded.
So here we go, the Nacho Time Challenge. A slightly harder than the Wing Challenge, and a tie and Wing Challenge, but this still isn't that hard if you want to know your shortcuts. Now, like I was talking, the second SpongeBob movie. Oh, look at that, I got an upgrade point. That's helpful. But yeah. I like the second SpongeBob movie, but I don't think it's as good as the first one. Like, this random dolphin called Bubbles appears, I don't know. Right, I think the time the travel part of the story was kind of unneeded. Because we built the time machine to get back to play Secret Formula, but they didn't, so... I feel like the time machine plot was pretty damn unnecessary. And the only reason why they had the time machine is so they can introduce a character Bubbles, which really his only purpose, so that they can... allow the characters to breathe in the real world. But even though they breathe the air fine in the first day, but yeah, I digress. Like I said, maybe Bowles gave SpongeBob DB the brain secondary and that carries on to the first day, I don't know. But yeah. Again, SpongeBob Underwood is a good movie. I think it just has some flaws that makes it a bit worse than the first movie. I don't think the story is as epic as the first one. But anyways, that's my personal opinion. As for speaking of SpongeBob Hero Pants, we can all agree that SpongeBob Hero Pants is a terrible, terrible game. And I don't plan to LP it anytime soon because I don't even own it. But anyways, that's my four on the second movie and first movie two, I guess. And we're halfway done with the Macho Time Challenge. Now you gotta go through this course in 3 minutes and 15 seconds, which it's only 25 seconds left. So this is not the hard one, as you know, all shortcuts are, of course. So, why are we at the end? And once we finish this off, we can end of the episode. Again, I think this point taking this shortcut is mandatory by now, but again, it's a whiskey shortcut, and yeah. Take this turn, and there you go. We're done with the same amount of time. Who would have thought?
You guys rock, as promised.
Oh boy!
You've beaten everyone's time.
I do what I can.
As do I.
Then how about beating your best time?
No, there's no point to beating your time. So instead, I'm gonna kill myself. If this whaling was in the way. Oh, well, I'll go to the left then. Hi, Handy. How are you doing? So, yeah, that'll do it for episode 4. Let's play the SpongeBob SquarePants new video game. Next time on Let's Play the SpongeBob SquarePants new video game, we shall be doing Bubble Blowing Baby Hunt in the Fuck Tug. So, this is Morgan and Who. I'll see you for some bubble blowing, smashing action. See you later, guys.